I'm Katie Smith. I play professional basketball, but I'm gonna give you a little bit of a history of kind of where it all started and what I've done in my playing career.
Big time three for Katie Smith. She hits the shots when the Mystics need to score.
She is playing as good a basketball as she has in her entire career right now.
So I grew up in Logan, Ohio, which is an hour southeast of Columbus. And I first started playing organized basketball in the fifth grade for the Bobcats. And it was an all-boys team. I was the only girl at that time. They didn't have as many teams or girls teams at that time. So I played with all my buds. And that's where it all began. And I've been playing ever since. But right after the Bobcats, you know, I was tall, I was coordinated, kind of fell in love with basketball at that time. And obviously went into seventh and eighth grade. I played summer basketball, AAU at that time, with people from the area and some of the other high schools that were close by. You know, I went to Logan High School. I played on the varsity team for, you know, 4 years. We had some success. We went to the state tournament 2 years. One, we dropped down to Division II and made it to the state tournament, but did not win. And in my senior year, we went to the state tournament and played against a powerhouse, a high school powerhouse in Pickerington. We lost, but it was one of my most favorite memories in my career of basketball, because it was at St. John Arena here in Columbus, Ohio, at Ohio State University, and it was sold out. It was, I think all of Logan was there. They joked that last person at least turned the light off. We were purple and white. Pickerington was purple and white. And there was a lot of basketball fans. So it's still to this day, it was one of my favorite memories. And I love St. John Arena. So that's kind of where that came. I got recruited throughout my high school career and even throughout junior high. I would get, you know, letters from colleges. And we would go to unofficial visits and visit places. And obviously, Ohio State University was always on my list, being kind of my hometown university. And ultimately, you know, I chose Ohio State is where I wanted to go to school and also play basketball. So I became a Buckeye in 93. And I was there from 93 to 96. But really started off at Ohio State with a bang. Had no idea. We had a really good senior class and we had a really solid freshman class. We had five of us. And we just kind of, we all meshed. And we started out and playing and winning and had some kind of signature wins. We played UVA on national TV. I guess it was maybe my coming out party. I had 35 points against a powerhouse. You know, UVA had been in the tournament and had success. So we kind of just kept winning. We won the Big Ten. We had some sellouts. And then obviously went on into the NCAA tournament and made it to the Final Four. But what a run. Like the fans, again, that's another one of my favorite memories, is that tournament run with our teammates, the fans, you know, Buckeye Nation. And we ended up playing in Atlanta at the Final Four. We beat Iowa again, one of our Big Ten foes, in the semis. Ended up playing Texas Tech in the finals. Cheryl Swoops, who had an amazing college career and also professionally in Olympics. We ended up running into her and we lost by two. She had 47 points, so we were hoping to keep her to 44, might have won the game. But it was still, again, just such an unbelievable run and the memories with all the fans and the players and my team. It was a blast. So throughout college, you know, I think when I was growing up, the Olympics kind of popped in there. You know, I never thought I'd play professional basketball. But when you're growing up, I loved watching the Summer Olympics. I just thought it was so cool, like representing your country. But I also, you kind of wondered, like, how do they get there? So it was always in the back of your head. And then when basketball kind of progressed for me and I was in college, I got a chance to represent USA basketball in some junior world championships and some other competitions, which are kind of the feeder programs into the Olympic team. But I was able to try out for the Olympic team in 96, my senior year, but I was an alternate. But that 1996 Olympic team really put women's professional basketball on a map. They created both the ABL and the WNBA out of that season. They trained all year. They did promotional stuff. They got investors. But they created the two professional leagues that jumped off in 1996. Obviously, so you have two professional leagues and then you have the Olympics. So I didn't make it in 96 in the Olympics, but my goal was in 2000 to be able to make that team, and be able to represent my country. And that was my thought. I thought I'd go on to dental school. I thought I'd play in the Olympics, and I thought I would, go off and work on people's mouths and teeth. But little did I know that the two leagues that were created because of the 96 Olympics would then change my world basically forever, and be doing things that I never really thought I would do as a kid. So the Olympics, we'll go one way. We'll talk about the Olympics. So in 2000, I was lucky enough was honored to be able to make the 2000 Olympic team, which was in Sydney, Australia. I was also lucky enough to continue to play, and I also played in 04 and 08 in the Olympics. 04 was in Athens, Greece, and 08 was in Beijing, China, where all three, we won gold medals, and just such an amazing experience to represent your country, your family, your city, your university, your hometown. Like, it's really like you're just taking everybody with you. And you just are just honored and very proud to be able to be there, because you know they all had a hand in what you did. So the Olympics kind of spanned, you know, my playing career, but you know, what really took off was, as I said, the ABL and the WNBA were two professional leagues that started right after my senior year. I graduated, I finished my 4 years at Ohio State, and the ABL and the WNBA started. So I literally stopped playing in college and moved right on over playing professional basketball. And as I said, I didn't think I would play very long. I'd play a few years, play in the Olympics, and kind of move on into quote unquote a real job. But little did I know, I played professional basketball for 17 years, and I retired when I was 39 years old. I had an amazing career. I was lucky to be able to play as long as I did, and to call it quits when I was able, when I wanted to, when I was ready. It doesn't always happen for players. But initially, I also think it was a blessing too. When I first got out of college at Ohio State, the first professional team I joined was in the ABL, the American Basketball League. It was the Columbus Quest. So it was right here in Columbus, Ohio. So the fans that kind of knew me as a kid, and watched me play in high school, in college, who you have some interaction with, and then I got to develop relationships with, friendships, and hang out with, and they've known you for so long. So then you found this niche and friends and people that are going to support you forever. So got lucky to play with the Columbus Quest, and we had so much success there. We had two ABL championships. Brian Agler, who went on to coach in the WNBA as well, was exceptional coach. Other players, elite, you know, Olympians, players that played overseas. We just had a great team. We had a lot of fun, and we were really successful. The ABL did go bankrupt, so it folded, and we were lucky enough that the WNBA was still going on, and all of us kind of moved on over. We're able to keep playing. And my journey kind of started in Minnesota. So I played with the Minnesota Lynx of the WNBA for 6.5 years. We didn't win a bunch there, but, you know, was able to love the city, love the fans. And ultimately, I got traded to Detroit, to the Detroit Shock, which ultimately ended up being one of the best moves for myself, but also for Minnesota. They got bad so they could get good, and I went to Detroit, was able to win two championships there, and also one of my favorite stops as a player, one of my favorite places to play, my teammates, my coaches. I played under Bill Laimbeer, assistant coach Rick Mahorn, and Cheryl Reeve, who Cheryl Reeve right now is she's the head coach of Minnesota. She is one of the best in the business. And also somebody I call a friend. So your relationships that you build throughout this. So I ended up in Detroit for, I think, 5.5 years or 4.5 years. And then I kind of bounced around to Washington, to Seattle for two, New York for one, which is where I ended up retiring, and then moving over into the coaching side. So it's, as I said, the 17 years of professional basketball ended up, you know, being able to play, being able to be in three Olympics and other international experiences. And then I also got a chance to play overseas. I played in Poland for 2 years, and I also played in Turkey, so for Fenerbahce, for a couple club teams. And that's just an experience in itself of being able to spend time and actually living in the country, try to figure out how to go to the grocery store, how to get places. But the teammates over there, just so much fun just to hang out, and they love to share, you know, their country with you. So it's a little journey into my playing days. As I say, when I was growing up playing for the Bobcats in fifth grade and going through high school, had no idea that basketball would take me all these places and meet these, you know, all these amazing people, and really my friends for life. And also has given me my career.